I have just had some good news. Yesterday, Michel of the Resistance managed to secure the German plans to invade England, which he smuggled to us on microfilm, disguised as a beauty spot on a red thigh. It was not easy for me to recover. Also, they have stolen two landmines from the Germans' truck, which they led into a large hole in the middle of the town square. Now this hole was formed by my wife Edith when she blew up the village sewage system with an exploding camembert cheese, which she inadvertently lit. These things happen. Now these two landmines are safely stored in the outbuildings next to my cafe, complete with the two British airmen who leave for England tonight. I did not tell you, we have been training a long-distance duck. The British have said to us to fly back important information. If all else fails, we may eat her. So, all is well. And therefore, you find me happily sampling one or two vintages to find a suitable housewine for my cafe. Ah, too good for the peasants. Too bad for the peasants. Good enough for the Germans. This one will do very nicely. Go and put another pint of antifreeze in this
one. Oh, and there you have one smaller smile on your face.
Well, it is because the British airmen leave us tonight for good, disguised as German landmines. Also, the microfilm is ready to leave by long distance duck. Our cafe will be back to normal. So for the time being, we can make as much money out of this war as we can.
Well, I'll drink to that.
Oh, Ecker. I knew it could not last. I have a bad feeling about today.
Listen very carefully. I will say this only once. When we stole from the Germans the landmines in which the two British airmen are to escape to England, we had to remove 1,000 kilos of high explosive. You are probably wondering what has happened to this explosive.
To tell you the truth, I never gave it a thought.
I will tell you now. Eden in a pudding factory.
Oh, what a good hiding place.
Unfortunately, we have secret information that this factory is to be commandeered by the Germans for the manufacture of a frozen strudel which is to be sent in food parcels to the Russian front. We could pass this secret information on to the British Marine in London today. We must not let this explosive fall into German arms. So, we have arranged for it to be delivered here to your cafe.
1,000 kilos of high explosive? Now listen, we were meant to buy 1,000 kilos of high explosive. If the Germans find even 1 kilo, I will be shot.
Do not worry. It will be disguised as a product of the factory.
What? High explosive strudel?
Did you think we are fools? We know you do not have a big enough refrigerator. How will you disguise it then? It will be disguised as 500 Christmas puddings.
I am out of your mind. What reason can I give for having 500 Christmas puddings in my cafe in the middle of July?
You can say you are starting a pudding club.
They cannot have gone far. I have a hunch. A spell? I don't live.
It is time we took a closer look. You and I, von Schmorlausen, must discover what these meetings are about. Come behind this screen. I have something I want you to try for size.
Bertie, where are you?
I am behind the screen with von Schmorlausen.
May one inquire what you are up?
We have removed our clothes in order to follow the Führer's instructions.
I see. What exactly did he tell you to do?
We have disguised ourselves in order to mingle amongst the peasants of the village without to ourselves drawing attention.
What a transformation!
What are you planning to do with that?
I thought you might feel like a little nipple later on.
You look so French. May I kiss you?
You may, briefly.
Enough.
Oh, thank you.
But Schmorlausen, walk this way.
This way.
I have instructions from Michel de Resistance. She says no matter what obstruction I encounter, that goes up your back at all. To my ladder. Oh, yeah, quick, take it through, quickly. Quickly. I love you, I love you. Okay. What about the other five?
The other five what?
The other five coffins with a 290 exploding Christmas pudding.
Oh, no, no, no. Oh, just another day in Wartown France.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is once more cabaret time here at Café René. First, we have for your enjoyment that delightful young lady that has given me many hours of pleasure. Listening to her lovely voice. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Yvette!
A couple of years ago, he was as I see him in the street, he's cast a certain shade. I fast in his attraction for a couple of hours or so. His manners could have been much more meticulous. If he were here or not, I couldn't tell. But like a silly fool, I fell. Mad about the boy. I'm so ashamed of it, but must admit the sleepless nights I've mad about falling. Walking down the street, I see his face in all the people that I meet. And so I'm quite aware that here and there are places on of misery, of joy. I'm feeling quite insane and young again, and all because I'm mad about the boy.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have for you from your very own village of Nouvion, the lovely Nouvionettes with a little number from across the seas. Take it away, les Nouvionettes!
Because it always plays the moment, here's a little bit, it really breaks.
How quickly it comes around. Ladies and gentlemen, we have for you now your own, your very own Nightingale of Nouvion, Madame Edith.
Just as
this morning when I was unblocking the kitchen sink here before came flooding back. Not be much of a surprise after 25 years.
I will be doing it your favourite way.
Doing what?
Frog in the hole!
Saw a short time ago, tasting his wines with not a care in the world. You see before you a man who had been encumbered with several coffins, two priceless stolen paintings, namely the fallen Madonna with the big boobies by Van Gogh, and the cracked vase with the big daisies by Van Gogh, both now secreted in two large German canoplasts. And last, but by no means least, 500 iron explosive Christmas puddings. Oh, you would not wish it on a dog. I am still looking forward to the day when the two British airmen leave us for good and Edith develops a terminal case of laryngitis. Meanwhile, it is almost lunchtime here at Cafe Rene, and you know what that means.
Good plate of
my share, please. And then I want to start again. I want some food today. I want some food today. Before I fade away. I want some food today. I want some food today. I want some food today. Before I fade away. I want some food today.
And when you are done, you will come back here immediately so I can
You believe me?
I understand, will there be anything else?
Yes, you may cut this one first. It's one of them. Up!
Then we'll form you by a Christmas pudding. Secondly, The two landmines are to be transported to the warehouse tonight. You must make sure that the two British airmen are in there by 1800 hours.
I cannot wait to get rid of them.
Oh, and I need two exploding Christmas puddings to pop down the funnel of the 1215 police.
No, naturally. No reason why the art of ballroom dancing should be lost forever. Now we met a one, a two, a one, two, three. Very good, Yvette. You are coming along very nicely. Now get back to work. There's a good serving girl.
Oh, Renee. I am a silly little schoolgirl. What is the matter with me that I could doubt a husband such as you? Oh, Renee. You know I have all eyes only for you. I will go to the shop of Madame Leland, and I will buy something to make you say once more that you love me.
Madame Leland sells dumb scoops.
In the shop of Madame Leland, there is a see-through nightdress.
She is more ruthless than the Gestapo.
Good moaning.
What do you mean, good moaning? It is not moaning, meaning bowler.
You admit that I am the scoops. There's a French pussent.
How much more of this can I take?
I wish to buy a Christmas pudding.
What are you doing here? It is almost 1800 hours.
Jolly rotten nut there, Fairfax. I think we've been rumbled. We only want a quick snort before we gallop, Cap. Jolly long trip. Oh. And what?
Get them back to the outhouse immediately and don't say a word about them to anyone.
My lips are soiled.
Full judicial order.
Yvette, two Christmas puddings!
Monsieur?
Make that four Christmas puddings!